Because we ended up with two pieces of last year's Christmas fruitcake from the last one you picked.
Yeah!
Whatever house you pick better be good.
Good? You want good? This will be better than good. This one will be great. And I want that.
Babies or something? This place ain't that bad.
Well, look at it, Matt. It looks like it's haunted. Let's just go home and watch Halloween Havoc and forget all about this one. We've got plenty of candy already.
Wah, wah, who cares about candy? I came here to see something scary. Cool.
I think I hear Mom calling.
Sisters, what a pain. Who brought her?
Hi, kids.
Wow, it's Tony Schiavone. Hey, shouldn't you be at the pay-per-view?
I have a helicopter waiting to pick me up in a few minutes.
What's that smell, Tony?
It's my wife. She's baking cookies. Would you kids like to have some?
What kind are they?
Only a kind a mother could make. Why don't you come inside and have a bite of her cookies?
We have enough treats already. We came here to see something scary.
You want to see something scary? I'll show you something scary. Who's that? Kids want a little fright in your night, huh?
Gee, Mrs. Schiavone, how did you get up there so fast?
Don't you kids know? All things are possible on All Hallows Eve. Frightening, chilling things like...
Will Vega versus D2000. Gordon Gaines versus Dane Xavier. Chris Proudfoot versus Dice. Scorpion versus Piper versus Angelo Morocco. Or Justin Lee, Xander and Kane for the national championship.
Not gonna be scary. If you can't come up with something better than that, we are leaving.
Okay. I've had it, all right? You guys want to be really scared?
Get a load of this. Ladies and gentlemen, I am back. Jay Balboa here, and we have the Halloween Havoc main card. Happy Halloween to everyone watching, and I hope you guys enjoy it. We got one hell of a slobber knocker for you here. Chris Proudfoot takes on Dice.
This is the opening contest of Halloween Havoc. The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 220 pounds, Chris Proudfoot.
There he is, the current contract and the case holder, making his way to the ring and facing his biggest challenge of his career. Taking on the former world champion, Dice.
And his opponent from Houston, Texas, weighing in at 214 pounds, this is Dice.
Proudfoot and Dice, one on one. Ring a ding ding. Let's get this underway. As these two men go to do their taunts now on their separate corners, trying to get the crowd behind each of every one of them. Nice reversal there by Proudfoot off the back. And this is an interesting matchup too, because if Proudfoot would have cashed in on Dice. We could have been seeing this for the world title. But Dice, after losing to D2000 at Fall Brawl, we get this match non-title. Chris Proudfoot looking to prove himself against the self-proclaimed gatekeeper of ROC, the Dice Man. And now stomping on the hand of Dice, weakening the arm of the former world champion. Up with a younger competitor, maybe a little too cocky here with the taunts early on in the matchup. That's something I don't like to see. And look at that, you pay for it. That's what happens when you taunt Dice. Repeated kicks now, the striking combination. Oh, what a follow up by a big running kick to the chest. And a moonsault. The offense early on by Dice. This is what he's known for. Two. Oh! Almost enough to put away Chris Proudfoot. And now attacking the head as well with a nice move there. Gonna break the neck. Interestingly, Proudfoot wearing a mask here in this matchup for the Halloween show. He did say in a promo, Proudfoot wisely moving out of the way. Did say in a promo leading up to the match that he was gonna try to scare Dice and get it in his head. And that mask is pretty creepy. But Dice came out with a mask of his own. A tribute to an anime Tokyo Ghoul, coming out with a Ken Kaneki mask. The One-Eyed King. And he's going to prove that he is the One-Eyed King here tonight as he takes on Chris Proudfoot. Proudfoot, though, locking in the foot of Dice. And they make that foot not proud. And now he's attacking the leg again. Weakening the legs of Dice. Dice known for some high-flying moves in his arsenal. So it's probably pretty smart of Proudfoot to do this. Airship reversal now by Dice. Oh, Spinebuster! Now locking in the head. We get some chain grappling now in this match. Proudfoot shifting his body weight. Getting back to his feet. Oh, in the elbow. Another one. Proudfoot with the upper hand, goes for a kick. Dice see it coming though. And an elbow to the face. That mask can only do so much when you're getting elbowed in the jaw. Proudfoot fighting out of another hold. Proudfoot a technician in the ring, and he's gonna see these moves coming and able to grapple out. Looking for what looks like a neck breaker here. Oh! Nice move by Proudfoot. And once again, calling to his savior, God, for some advice, but he should look at Dice, and he pays for taunting. As Dice gets the upper hand here. Oh, he got him in an arm bar. He's got him in an arm bar. Up without moving, but Dice holding it in. Now has another submission move in. Oh my God, he's gonna break his damn arm. Oh God. That's gotta hurt. Proudfoot wisely rolling out and trying to get his bearings here. Dice loving every minute of this. That's the thing with Dice, he loves a good challenge, and Proudfoot seems like he's been giving him one. Oh, Proudfoot caught Dice! Caught Dice, got a drop kick! Caught Dice taunting there. And hit the nice drop kick. Oh, but Dice wisely with a nice reversal. Now, oh my God, that's gotta hurt so badly. Just wrenching on that neck, ripping the spine forward. The repeated elbows by Proudfoot. You gotta think what a big match this has gotta be, not just for Proudfoot, but for Dice, because of that loss against D2000. He wants to get back in that title picture. He wants to do something here. Oh, Proudfoot looking for that final confession. Is he going to hit it? No, Dice sees it coming. He gets out of the way. Now Dice, nice suplex by the Dice Man. Offense back in Dice's favor. Oh, they knee into the gut. Dice is looking to fly. Oh, too close. Proudfoot was too close to the corner there. It's one jump too far. Miscalculated there by Dice. And a nice move by Proudfoot. Off of that screw up by Dice, getting the offense back in his favor. And now the repeated elbows to the dome piece of Dice. Proudfoot looking to return the favor and fly here himself. Oh, just dropping the chest right across Dice. That's going to hurt both men, though, as he's seen Proudfoot wincing as he got back to his feet. Now stomping on the hand of the former world champion. We've seen that earlier on. There's no respect from Proudfoot to Dice. This man is a leader of some kind of crime syndicate. And he's showing just how ruthless and merciless he can be. But Dice is no stranger to that, as he sends him out back with an Irish whip of his own. Proudfoot, nice reversal there, though. The technician back at it again. What's Dice looking for here? Setting Proudfoot up. Oh, my God. Big backbreaker coming up. Oh, my God. God, that elevated backbreaker does so much extra damage as Dice goes for the win. Two. Oh! Almost a three count. Is Dice looking for off the ropes? Oh! Proudfoot sees it coming. Oh! But Dice still feeds him a nice kick to the head. A locking in the arms here. Oh my God, disrespectful. Punch, but no Proudfoot sees it coming. Oh, goes for that northern knockout, but Dice reverses it. I think after all these reversals on the signatures and finishing moves of Proudfoot, Dice did his homework here. If he was going up against the contracted case holder. Oh, clotheslines Proudfoot off to the outside of the ring. Both men are down, but Dice back to his feet now. Off the ropes, what's Dice looking for? He's flying, oh, right on top of Proudfoot. Chris is dazed and confused. Something Proudfoot's used to, though. Every weekend night, he gets a little dazed and confused. So, oh, he's looking a little more dazed, confused after this. Dice sends him outside through the barricade. The crowd chanting, "This is awesome." That was sure as hell awesome. As Proudfoot was sent through that barricade. We're up to a six count now. Count with 6 minutes to go, now a seven. But Dice breaking up the count. He doesn't want to end it that way. Oh! Proudfoot wisely getting out of the way. Elbow to the back now by the foot. And repeated kicks. Another one, weakening the legs of Dice. And now the elbows to the head. To a four count. These men battling on the outside of the ring. Both of them no strangers to getting a little extreme here in these matches. Proudfoot sending Dice right in that apron. His stomach just being thrust into it. Eight. Is Proudfoot going to win? By count out? Oh, wait. No, he's going to fly. Oh, he misses, though. We seen that earlier with Dice missing on the 450. Proudfoot missing of a flying forearm himself, and now Dice is going to capitalize. With a foot DDT to Proudfoot. Now controlling the body. It looked like Proudfoot didn't really want to win on a count out either. As both of these men, but he wanted to still attack Dice. And now Dice attacking him now with a big boot. Get back in the ring, though. Dice looking to fly here on Proudfoot. Chris, though, getting back to his feet. Goes for the elbow. Oh, Chris gets out of the way. Goes next kick there to weaken Dice. And a big booty bounce by Chris Proudfoot. Oh, he's looking at that top rope. What's the foot looking for here? Big elbow. Going for the pin off the elbow. Oh, only a one count, though. You got to do more than that to put away Dice. And what's Chris looking for here? Lifting Dice up with his foot. Oh, damn. Huge kick to the head of Dice. Two. Oh, no. Looks like Dice barely got the shoulder up there. I would doubt. Oh, what is it? Proudfoot raking the eyes. Come on. And now the chops to the chest after such a dirty maneuver. Oh, northern knockout. Northern knockout by Chris Proudfoot. And the pin. One. Two. Oh. Dice just kicking out there. Barely staying alive in this matchup is Dice. And Proudfoot looking to put him away. Going for that final confession, but no, Dice gets out of the way again. He's seen that coming. Could see the move of his own coming here. Nice kick by Proudfoot. But no, Dice reads it, sends him out of the ring. Oh, Dice! Oh, shooting star press! Proudfoot is down and out. Dice picking him back up now and throwing him back in the ring. Oh, big elbow, but Proudfoot gets out of the way. Barely surviving there. He's rolling out wisely as Proudfoot looks on in the ring. And now all Proudfoot turns his back on Dice for a second, and he should have done that face first into the mat. Now Dice with the upper hand here. And locking in the arm. He sees that there's only 2 minutes left and he looks to put him away. But no, he pulls it out of it. Maybe he was just trying to weaken the arm there. Hecking Proudfoot pulling him up. I'm not sure what he's thinking here. He's got a, oh! God, it's gonna try to knock him out. Oh, big knee by Dyson. Go for the pin. One, two. Oh, Proudfoot just able to kick out. Oh, Dice. Irish whip. Knocks out the referee. Proudfoot breaks the eye, though. Gallows chops to the chest as the referee tries to get back to his feet. Up and looking to capitalize, but the ref's already back up. Now the count continues. What's Proudfoot thinking here? Oh my God, oh my God, oh the knees! Dice just getting the knees up. Now, he crushed her! On the outside! Jesus! With only a minute left, Dice is looking to win it all. Huge stop! Maybe going for a pin off that, and Dice is thinking the same thing. One, two, three, no! Proudfoot! Just able to kick out. Oh my God, with a minute left. Can't believe it. I can't believe he just kicked out of the ace crusher and the stop, but Dice now coming back here with a drop kick and another one. Wait, no, Proudfoot gets the upper hand there. 35 seconds. Irish whip in the corner by Proudfoot as he's tiredly walking. Wait, we've seen this before. Chucking Dice on the corner. And what's he looking for? Final confession! He gets all of it! One, two, no! And Dice kicks out. 10 seconds left. Proudfoot's got to go for a pin or something. And he tries to go for another pin. Two. Oh, Dice kicks out a two again, and that's your match.
This match results in a draw.
What a way to start off the show here. Two great warriors battling it out to a draw. And next up, we've got the pure triple threat, non-title, I should add, between Angelo Morocco, Piper, and Scorpion. Let's take it to the ring for this match.
The following contest is a triple threat Iron Man match. Coming down the aisle from Scotland, weighing in at 258 pounds, Piper. And his opponent, from London, England, weighing in at 219 pounds, Scorpion. Coming down the aisle from the Bronx, New York, weighing in at 305 pounds, he is the ROC Pure Champion of the World, Angelo Morocco.
Ring a ding ding. Let's get this matchup underway here. I'm just glad I'm connected here. I'm glad I'm connected enough to get to sit front row to watch this incredible matchup as Morocco goes to work on Scorpion. Interesting stipulation here as well. Now, this is non-title, but if Scorpion can squeeze out a victory, he will get added to that matchup where Piper and Angelo will face for the world title at Homecoming. So if Scorpion can win with big drop kicks like that, he just might. He will get a title match against Angelo Morocco and Piper. Now him and Morocco had an incredible match at Fall Brawl. And now he gets to battle it out here. Oh, nice drop kick there by Scorpion. And Angelo Morocco, big spine buster. The power of Morocco is so incredible. This guy's a true hero. And that little strike, that MMA style of Morocco going to work. A powerhouse and an MMA competitor. You don't see that often in a wrestling ring. And Piper, oh, Piper the showman as always. And Scorpion, that Lucha Libre style, now locking in the arm. Trying to weaken the big man, but Piper, with the power, gets out of it. Oh, and Scorpion with a little power of his own. And now going on the attack with Angelo Morocco. And a pin on the champion, but only a one count. Spoon there by Scorpion as well. Now we've seen that with Angelo Morocco. The resiliency of this guy is so incredible. You're gonna have to do more than that to put him away. Oh, nice move there by Scorpion. Just a slam down to the mat. Oh, and he misses though. Looks like Morocco got out of the way. He's seen it coming. These two know each other so well. Oh, look, he's lifting him up here. Scorpion, big suplex. As Piper outside of the ring. And he slides back in. Scorpion should look behind him. Oh, raking the back. What a dirty move there. It looks like an electric chair, but no, Scorpion fighting out of it. Pulling him up here, open a pin. Angelo Morocco wisely breaking that up. A suplex there by Morocco. Now, oh, just tossing Piper across the ring. The one-eyed warrior didn't see that coming. Oh, look at that. Piper and Scorpion battling on the outside. Oh, reverse atomic drop there. Now Piper just tossing him around. And kick. What's Morocco looking for? Oh, on the mat. Morocco with the offensive advantage here early on in this matchup. Going to work on his competitors. Big punches in the corner there. And now some more strikes. This pure champion is purely amazing. What he's looking for. Oh! Big backbreaker, but Scorpion! He gets it. Just tipping Morocco down. He was gonna go fly, but had second guessed it. And now Scorpion and Piper battle it out in the middle of the ring. Oh, fighting out of it, Scorpion. Going for another pin. No, he didn't connect with the pin. He just threw him down there. But he wanted to go up. Oh, backstabber! By Morocco. One, two. Not enough to put away Scorpion though. Rolling around on the ground. Oh, nice reversal. He possumed him there. It looked like Morocco did the same thing. Oh, goes for the Kamehameha, but misses wildly. And a spine buster by Morocco. Angelo's been the dominant factor here in this matchup here, not letting anyone get anything on him. Knowing that he'd earned that pure title around his waist. What kind of move he's going for here? What the? Oh my god! Oh, it's Scorpion, but looks like Scorpion broke up the pinfall attempt there by Morocco. Oh, and Angelo sending Score Predator out of the ring and going for a pin again. One. Only a one count, though. Too much time had passed thanks to Scorpion breaking that up. Just enough time that Piper was able to survive after that tremendous power bomb off the top rope. That's a great strike there, but Scorpion comes up from behind. Oh, nice move there by Scorpion. Big punch, though, by Scorpion. Oh, goes for the Kamehameha, but oh, a backhand shot. And now the striking combination from the Scottish Warrior. Oh, wait, Scorpion says no. And a dab. But he should be dabbing on his, on looking at the fucking pure champion. Oh, just dropping Scorpion. And Angelo Morocco is on a roll tonight, proving to the world why he is the pure champion. Oh, Mills Piper proving to the world why he's the number one contender for that title. So Morocco kicks out at one. This New York firefighter is no joke, making quite a name for himself in ROC. Piper, though, the power of Piper. Oh, just tossing Morocco. And Scorpion go for the pin here. One. Oh, only a one count. Impressive matchup from all three of these competitors as Morocco and Piper get back to their feet. Nice drop kick by Scorpion. And off the rope. Oh, landing right on Piper. And going for the pin. But Morocco's right there. Scorpion wisely gets up. And oh my God, oh, Morocco. One, two, oh, Piper just able to break it up. Came right to his senses at the right time. Kicks now, this is vintage Morocco. Oh, bring him down. Scorpion now going for the pin, sneaking it in. Two, almost a three count from the pure champion. And Angelo wisely rolling out after barely kicking out of that move. Scorpion gets in with the elbow. And here it is, end of day. And the pin, one, two, three. There's the first point for Piper. And now he's flexing on him. Oh, but Scorpion flexing back. Irish whip. He's the gut there. Piper on the ground, writhing in pain. And Scorpion should be watching out for Morocco as he sends him from the top rope. And now Morocco signaling for it. Oh, Scorpion though. Able to get the elbow in. The gut looks over that big DDT. And the pin. Oh no, Piper's right there. He wants to save that point and make sure that Angelo doesn't get one to tie it up. And Scorpion doesn't want Piper to get another pinfall there either. Oh, Piper. One count though. Scorpion staying alive here. Next move there by Scorpion. He's got to watch out for Morocco. Always sneaking around, looking for that opportunity to strike. Oh, and he's sending it on the outside. Oh my God, double knee to the chest of Angelo Morocco. And now Piper to the top rope. What's he looking for? Oh, just landing on top of him. I think he caught a fist right to Morocco's chest. Oh, he's got to look out, though. Big dropkick by Scorpion. And now Scorpion has the upper hand, the former pure champion, looking to prove why he deserves a shot at that title again. Once again, if he does win this match, he gets a shot at the pure title. He gets thrown into that one-on-one matchup, making it a triple threat for the pure championship. But he has to win here tonight to get that opportunity. And right now, he's a point behind with 5 minutes left. The clock is against him. Irish whip by Piper. Oh, big headbutt. And the always cocky Piper just taunting. Guns and poses may be gone, but the posing from Piper never stops. And Morocco, big, oh, big move there. That's the finisher right there. Two, three. Morocco ties it up with 4 minutes and 30 seconds left. Well, 4 minutes and 17, but close it up. Irish whip now. Piper wisely getting out of the ring after he was dismantled there by Morocco. And Angelo, with 4 minutes left, has to do something. He tries to sneak in a pin, but Piper always wisely, always there in the background. Oh, Morocco rolls him up. One. Oh, Scorpion breaks it up. And now putting the beat down on Scorpion. It's Morocco. Big move here by Piper. Scorpion was right there. Big drop kick. Kind of catapulted himself off of Piper there to get the drop kick and the pin too. Almost a three count. Scorpion desperately in need of a point here to tie things up. He's the only one who hasn't scored yet. He's looking to score here. Oh, super kick. Right when Morocco was tied up on that top turnbuckle. And now, Scorpion, the pin. One, two, three. Scorpion ties it up. It's one all. It's one all in a shooting star press. Onto the body of the pure champion. Oh, and misses the moonsault. Angelo was too close to the ring and looks like Scorpion misshot it there as Piper looks to capitalize on two of the former pure champions and sending Scorpion right into the steps. And now it's Angelo and Piper in the ring. Piper setting up Morocco on that top rope, that top turnbuckle, but Morocco says no. He literally says no there. And a huge, oh! Morocco and Scorpion. Oh, he misses the 450. Neither man knows what to do. Oh, Scorpion does with a big strike. Oh, and it catches him mid-air. From the pin. Two. Piper able to break it up. And Scorpion picking him up now. Well, Piper was picking up Scorpion there. Now Scorpion set up in that turnbuckle. Angelo says no. Nice reversal there by Morocco. But no. Scorpion's got to turn around because he's got, oh, he's got Morocco right there. One, two, three. Morocco takes the lead with a minute and 30 seconds left. And that's why he's the pure champion. Scorpion, though, desperately trying to tie things up. Not much time left, though. The former champion is on a time spree here. He needs to do something. He needs to get some kind of crazy combination. Oh, what a fucking sledgehammer. Piper, the dastardly warrior. Bastard he is with a dirty move. But no, Scorpion survives. And I thought this was a pure match, but the referee letting things go here in this incredible battle. One, two. Piper survives. I'm not sure what is going on here. This referee, this is supposed to be a pure match, and the referee letting it go. So I guess anything goes here tonight in this incredible battle between these three warriors. Not sure what Scorpion's going for here. He's got both men wherever he wants them. Oh, misses the elbow drop. Up. Morocco right there. Oh, hold up. now. Looking for it. Catches the midair, but Morocco takes the win.
Here is your winner, the pure champion of the world, Angelo Morocco.
These two will face each other at homecoming. A little sign of respect, but oh, never mind. Classic Piper. A dastardly move by the number one contender. And next up, after that incredible matchup, we're going to have some special guests here for you guys at Halloween Havoc. Ring of Kiss coming down the ring. That's what I like to see at Halloween Havoc. I am loving it. And next up, we got a match every single one of you is going to love as Dane Xavier goes one-on-one with Gordon Gaines Kemp. You better tune in for that one because it's going to be one hell of a matchup here at Halloween Havoc. Boom!
Beetlejuice.
It's showtime.
Shake, 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 Sinora, shake your body liner. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake it all the time.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle from Asbury Park, New Jersey, weighing in at 250 pounds, Gordon Gaines.
of weather, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you, jump in the line, rock your body on time. Okay, I believe
I gotta say, I think Gordon might have just won the costume contest here at ROC tonight. I am loving it. I gotta give you one of those shoots.
Shake, Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora, work your body line. Work, 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 Sinora, work it all the time.
I am inevitable.
And his opponent from Bad Street, Atlanta, GA, weighing in at 307 pounds, Daniel Xavier.
And never before had my opinion changed so quickly. Costume of the night has to go to Dane Xavier because Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good.
You know, I get the kilos, 50%. If you are not bilingual, get the fuck up out of town before we run your ass down. Underground, how I came out. Any nigga try to stop me, let it hang out. Let it bang, let it rain out. Woo! Yo soy el Dios, you are Dios, nigga. I am
inevitable.
Get a nigga chopped up on a Tuesday. White club going up on Tuesday. This is doomsday, I can have Guadalupe. Come through and knock down a truck by the toupee. Ho! Now look at his brains all on the sidewalk. I'm tucked with 38 and jump on my skywalker. Woo! I'm rolling. Shotgun, Cardio, Ochoa. I am
inevitable.
Through Sinaloa with the blood red Chuck Taylor's on, and you know when I show up with the squad full of killer squad, full of hit a squad, full of niggas that'll pull up, let it bark on a nigga. 106 shots bark on a nigga. Street sweeper at the whole block up, no spark on a nigga. Got 2 Glock 9s, 2 45s, 2 Desert Eagles, and he fly together side by side. No ego conmigo, tú sabes, amigo. No Tony Montana, mi amigos y kilos, mi casa, su casa. Cuidado con el chico, tú quieres la placa, yo tengo perico.
And ring-a-ding-ding, let's get this matchup underway here as the God looks to snap away his competition with a big backhand chop right off the bat, but Kemp, those gains are showing off as he uses the power to beat down the bigger Dane Xavier. And he's down to a knee as these two men square off. Backhand chop by Kemp. Dane taunting, and so is Kemp. Gives him one of his own. Oh, and a big elbow by Dane Xavier. And now a kick to the back. Dane has the offense where he wants it now. Putting the beat down on Gordon. Those big chops to the chest, though, again by Kemp. And now just taking him down into a pin. Never seen that before. Only gets the two count, though. Off the rope again. Dane, oh, come on, ref. You just poked him in the eye. Can't be letting that go. Dane, so agile, but so is Kemp with a nice jab to the face. And just tossing Dane Xavier around. And Dane back to his feet. Kemp was waiting for him. Nice Irish whip into the corner. And feeds him with a big punch. And now, oh God. A big DTA to Dane Xavier. And now, oh, just rubbing the feet on the mat. Pure disrespect to the God. But the God feeds him back and shows him this is why you gotta respect me. Oh, just tossing Kemp across the ring. And now he's lifting him up dead weight. with a nice German suplex. Only a two count, though. And now telling him to stay down. Butt headlock there. Dan Xavier has the upper hand and control of the match at this point. Camp thrown off. Oh, God, nice power slam there from Dan Xavier in the pin. One. Only a one count. Got to do more than that to keep Kemp down, it looks like, as Dane wrenches on the arm now. Oh, God, he's got it fully locked in. And again. Kemp's got to get out of it. Now he's got the leverage. Trying to fight out. Punch to the gut. And now a nice neck breaker. Or neck wrenching breaker move there by Gordon Kemp. And now to the middle rope. Oh, just dropping all that body weight right on top of him. Kemp's got to be looking for something here to put away Dane Xavier. We all know that's not easy to do. A pin will do it, though. It only gets the one. Big backhand chop there by Dane. Back and forth. Oh, another eye rake. Come on. One's enough. Just despicable. Kemp, though, fighting out of it despite the dirty tactics and gets a punch in the face for it. This is such a striking matchup here. All that body weight, so much. And it wasn't, Kemp couldn't lift it. That's one thing Kemp couldn't lift, was Dane Xavier, the massive frame of Dane. It's such an advantage over anyone here. Most competitors aren't big enough to compete with Dane Xavier. And now lifting Kemp up. And backhand chop again. A lot of woos in this matchup. And a huge boot. Kemp taking the big man down. The God is in trouble. Wait, looks like he flies out of it. Oh, nice boot there by Xavier. And now the nice jab combo, but Kemp AO, the Kemp on the outside now. Getting tossed back in by Dane. Irish whip, followed up, big move there, just tossing Kemp across, and a rope break, and his toes must have been hitting it, it looked pretty close, and Dane taunting to the crowd, at homecoming, I mean, this is going to be one hell of a contest. Dane is going to be taking on the national champion, whoever that may be. We're gonna find out in the main event. And I'm sure Dane looks forward to it, but tonight he's gotta look forward to Gordon Kemp feeding him those shots to the face. And you gotta know Dane Xavier is gonna be watching that main event very closely. Earning himself a shot at the national championship at Fall Brawl. Unfortunately, was not able to secure a world championship match. But he was able to earn himself a national championship match. But as I said, he's got to be thinking about Kemp right now as he's facing off across Gordon Gaines. He has been incredible as of late. The physique, the change of character for Gordon has been great for him. The fans are loving him. It's a resurgence for Gordon Kemp. But Dane wisely gets out of the way. And now, oh no, Kemp fighting out of that. And another takedown, but Dane says no. Off the ropes. Oh God. The full force of the God. Being struck upon Kemp and now deadlifting Gordon and slamming him to the mat. And this is something we always see from Dane, embracing the hate and embracing his followers here tonight at Halloween Havoc. Goes for the kick there. Kemp wisely reverses it into a big clothesline. And now flex it on him. Showing those gains. And tossing it back in the ring. Jab though by Dane Xavier. And now another taunt. And he backs away from the punch wisely, but gets tossed across the ring anyway. And this is like a pose-off almost. Both these men integrating the poses in this matchup here. Big move here. Another big clothesline from Gordon Kemp. Two. We're going to see an upset. No. Dane surviving in this matchup here. You gotta think, Dane kind of, he probably wants to get this match out of the way. Nice reversal by Dane Xavier, as I was saying. He probably wants to get this matchup out of the way and just focus on that national title match at homecoming. He wants to put Kemp behind him. And he's gonna look to do that here. Oh! Face first into the mat. And the pin, no, a rope break. And Dane Xavier is pissed. He's throwing a tantrum. He's just gonna kick him in the face, drag him, his limp carcass across the ring and go for another pin. One, only a one count. And Dane Xavier is in disbelief. Oh, Kemp fighting back. Nice press takedown. And now just the repeated punches. I guess that was more of a takedown than anything. That's Kemp looking for. Oh! Just slamming him down. Dane Xavier is in trouble. I did not expect to see Kemp having the upper hand here at this point in the match. Big improvements from Gordon Kemp. Now attacking the foot, a foot DDT. Not sure what he's thinking here. Trying to get in the head of Gordon Kemp is a tough task indeed. Irish whip by Dane. Off the ropes. Oh, he decides against it. Oh, goes for that huge boot. That could have been it, but a clothesline instead. Looking to put him away. Picks up the god. And, oh god! That's it. One, two, three. Gordon Kemp picks up the win.
Here is your winner, Gordon Gaines.
What a win by Gordon Gaines. Huge upset here at Halloween Havoc, and he's got to be happy about that one. What an impressive performance. Flex it on him now. No one can take that away from Gordon Kemp. What a huge win from Mr. Gaines here tonight. And next up, we got one hell of a matchup as Vega takes on D2000 in a non-title match. We're going to see hell be raised between two veterans here at ROC. Will Vega versus D2 comes right up.
On that gravy train, bitches, gravy train, gravy
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 236 pounds, Will Vega. And his opponent from Buffalo, New York, weighing in at 253 pounds, he is the ROC World Champion of the World, D2000.
Let's get this matchup underway here. Non-title, Will Vega takes on D2000. We're getting a treat here tonight, folks. Ring a ding ding. D2000 right on the attack right away. Oh, but Will Vega shifts the body weight to make sure he lands on top of D2. And this new, more vicious side of D2000 can be attributed to him winning that world title. Oh, big knee. Speaking of being vicious, sending D2 to the outside as Vega taunts the crowd. This is a huge opportunity for Will, getting to go one-on-one with the world champion. Big punch there. Earlier in the night, we got to see Alec Reyes, D2000's number one contender. He was unfortunately upset and eliminated early on in his triple threat match by London Mayhem. He will get a shot at D2000 one-on-one. And oh, D2 just tossing Will back in the ring. Big kick there as well. That's the thing with D2. He always follows up his moves with another move. Oh, shimmy, shimmy, and a knee to the face. Over a pin off that. Oh, he doesn't even want to get the three count. Just picks Will up. Yeah, nice fireman's carry by Will Vega. That's a pure disrespectful move to Will, though, to pick him up from the pin. And Will is not happy about it as he feeds D2 those strikes. D2000, though, eye rake. And gets punched in the gut for it. And as arm drag takedown by Will. Oh, followed up by another knee. Those are so vicious. And now just tossing D2000 across the ring. The champion is out of it here. And Will is on the attack. Loving every second of it. And now grabbing the neck. Oh, just dropping him. Going for the pin. One. Only a one count, though. You gotta take more than that to take away D2000, and now he's just getting frustrated here. Picking him up again and just tossing him across the ring. Will Vega is on a roll here tonight against the ROC World Champion of the World. But this is what D2000 needed. A little mistake from Will is all it takes to get the offense back in his favor with a nice hurricanrana. Telling him to stay down. Shimmy again. Oh! Drops the elbow or the knee. And now, nice suplex there by D2. Looks like he's looking for another one. Oh no, Will gets out of it. Another knee. Those vicious knee strikes by Will Vega adding up here tonight. And he gets another one. Vintage Will. Two. Almost a three count on the champ. Will Vega in disbelief. And it drops the elbow on him, brother. Going to that middle rope. Oh, off the top, never mind. Misses that elbow, though. And a big face to the mat. Going for the pin here. One, two, almost a three count. To put away a guy like Will Vega, you're going to need to hit some kind of finisher. He is no joke. The turnbuckle now. Irish whip followed up by the Buffalo Bulldog. And oh, no way. Not in Halloween Havoc. The world champion of the world going for that vintage move. And he gets the worm. He gets all of it. That could be enough to put away Will. Two. Oh, and Vega kicks out. And a drop in the knee now. Oh, repeated knees. Oh, this is vicious. This is despicable. And D2000 calling him on. Telling him, get in the ring. Let's go, pal. D2 looks to get the shot in, and he gets it. Nice haymaker punch there from the champ. Setting up Vega. Oh, my God. This is going to be brutal. Oh! Face first to the mat. D2000 looking to fly. Oh, goes for the leg drop. Misses, and Will Vega capitalizes. DDT! And the pin. One, two. Oh, no. D2000 kicks out. Will Vega in disbelief. I don't blame him. That would move and put away most men. But this cyborg is not most men. Big slap to the face. D2000 has the upper hand here. Twisting the neck around. Oh, and just throwing him down to the mat. Vega is in a state of confusion and gets followed up by a big back suplex. Going to that middle rope. Falls on the top. Oh, and he does a move. That move of his own. It hits it. Gets all of it. Two. Almost a three count. The champ has to be looking for something to to put away Vega here. Those punches were close to it, but no. Oh, what's Will looking for? Oh, nice move by Will. Only a one count, though. Now Vega, just the repeated punches to the face of D2000. Trying to weaken the champ, it looks like. Irish whip reversal by D2. Big punch. And is he looking to fly? Oh, he gets all of that elbow. Taunting to the crowd, this new vicious D2000 has been getting the job done. And he looks to do it again here. Oh my God, vintage. I hate when he does it. Oh God. Oh! Face first into that side of the ring. The hardest part of it. Six. Can we get a doctor out here? This is ridiculous. Seven. Vega is out of it. Oh wait, he's crawled back to his feet. Now he's back in the ring. Will's got some fight left in him. He's got a resurgence. He has a second wind here. Big kick off the ropes. Double knee. Vega is feeling it here tonight at Halloween Havoc. Oh! Huge move. One. He's gonna win! No! Vega unable to get the three count. D2 will not stay down for no man. Oh, and Vega now goes for it. Misses again, though. We seen D2 hit that earlier. Will tried it earlier as well. Wasn't able to hit it. It's a battle of the elbow drops here tonight. Irish whip in the corner now. Oh, and just dismantling the leg of Vega. He won't be doing any jumping for a while or seeing for a while after that huge boot to the face. And now the repeated stomps by our vicious world champion. Irish whip in the corner. Oh God, the power behind it too. What's he looking for? DDT by D2. Not sure what he's thinking from here now. Has Bill by the back of the head. Oh no. Oh no. Not to Vega. This man's a staple of ROC. Are you trying to end his damn career? Oh my God. Oh my God! No! One, two, three. It's over.
Here is your winner, D2000.
Another vicious display by D2000. And another, wait, what's he going? No, the match is over. What are you thinking? This is like just like a Cyber Slam. After what he did to one of his friends. Oh no! Someone get out here. We gotta stop this. This is ridiculous. Oh, come on. Oh my God. On the outside. Oh, I hope you're happy. I hope you're happy, D2, you sick monster. This isn't a cyborg. This is just a monster. This is your world champion. Wait up. Oh my God, it's Chris Brownfoot. He's got the contract in the case. Is he cashing in? Is he cashing in? It looks like it. Chris Crawford, wait, what? Will Vega? He stops the match from happening. Why would Vega do that? I have no idea what's going on here tonight in this matchup, but it's all over. And next up, we got our national championship match, the main event between Xander, Justin Lee, and Kane to find out who will be the national champion going into homecoming. So tune in for that match.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the main event of the evening. The following contest is an Extreme Rules Iron Man match, and it is for the National Championship of the World. Introducing challenger number one, from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 278 pounds, Xander. Introducing challenger number two, from Connecticut, weighing in at 322 pounds, he is one half of the ROC Tag Team Champions, Justin Lee. Next, from the depths of hell, weighing in at 666 pounds, he is the reigning, defending ROC National Champion of the World, it's gotta be Kane.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm speechless. I am terrified. I feel like these aren't just costumes. I feel like these are their true personas. These three giants, these three huge competitors competing for that national championship as Justin Lee goes to work on Xander. Or should I say Freddie goes to work on Jason. As Kane, aka Michael Frickin' Myers, is on the outside grabbing weapons already. I have a feeling we're in for a hellacious matchup. Justin Lee with a chair right to the face of Kane and gets Xander with it too. Going for a pin early on, but only a one count on Kane. And Xander now on the offensive. A huge opportunity for Xander. No Justin Lee. It looks like he wants to become a double champion here. And if he can win the title, he'll do just that here tonight. And what's that? Looks like Kane's got that steel chair. Oh, but the steps are stronger. That nice suplex there by Justin Lee. And Xander breaks it up with the steps. He doesn't want Lee to get a point. We've seen a match like this earlier on, and it's so true. You don't want your opponent to get any points, because they all add up over the course of the 15 minutes. And now Kane with the strikes on Xander. Oh, huge punch. In the offense now by Kane. Big clothesline by the champ. Oh, and those steps are so vicious. And Lee has been dominant with them thus far in this matchup here. Oh my god. Oh! Geez, the extra bonus from the turnbuckle pad. Plus the steps. I've never actually seen that before, I don't think. What a great move there by Justin Lee. And I use great in the loosest terms because it's vicious. And speaking of vicious, he just slammed Kane on the steps. And now he's slamming Xander on him too. Justin Lee is unstoppable here tonight. He's like a thing from your nightmares. Oh, and so is Kane. Tossing Justin Lee around like a ragdoll. Oh, again. Flipping the steps. But now Xander getting involved here. Oh. Knee across the back. And he bounced off those steps as he fell. A nice clothesline by Kane. Up behind you, though, because Justin Lee's got the ladder. Oh, no, he's setting it up. sure what he's thinking here. Great move by Kane, and out gets the table in the face. Now Xander with the table in his back. Justin Lee is dominant with the weapons here tonight. Xander tripping off the ladder and gets a nice elbow to the face. That mask can only cover so much. And he gets a point. Xander fell victim to the strike again. And it just cost him a point in this match. And now Justin Lee looking for another. Oh, we kicked out of one. Will Xander choke again in a title match? We just see a huge upset there. He's got to recuperate. All these men got to recuperate because Justin Lee is on fire in tonight's matchup. He is hungry, but so is Kane. And Lee wisely rolling out there. This is Xander, and a nice punch in the face by Xander. We're seeing Jason versus Michael Myers right now in the ring. And Jason has the advantage. Oh, not for long. Sending Xander into the table. Not sure what Kane is thinking here. Oh my God. Oh my God! Through the table. Now he's got those steps. Oh, this is just despicable. Not sure what's going on. Oh, those steps again beat the chair. And now Kane lifting Xander up. And oh, just the knees. And then slamming him down. And Justin Lee flies across the ring. Not sure Kane now. Lifting him up. Slamming him down at the knee again, and we see this earlier. Oh! Now both men on the apron. Looks like Xander and Kane are gonna go at it. Xander feeding him those feet to the face. This match is so hectic, we need two referees here just to call the action. This is insanity tonight. This is your main event of Halloween Havoc, and it has been Havoc thus far. Justin Lee bringing in more steps. We got two of them. The action has slowed down to a standstill as all these men try to figure out what their next plan of attack is. And Kane takes out both men. Going for the pin. 1, 2, 3. Oh my God. Xander gets pinned again. Now Kane and Justin Lee both have a point here. Xander has got to do some catching up. This is one of those performances that he's known for. He has to change things tonight. This is his chance. And now, oh, Lee hits him from behind. He might have just saved Xander's life as both those steps were set up there. And now, oh, Xander doesn't return the favor. And Lee gets sent into both of those steps with a sizzling maneuver. The demon from hell, Kane. But now Xander is on the attack. What the hell is that? Oh my God. I'm not even sure what to call that. That was an incredible move by Xander. And now he's feeling it. He could be looking for that big move. X-Bomb! And Justin Lee looking to steal it. But Xander breaks it up. And gets a suplex turn. 1, 2. Only a two count. Xander able to survive. But he's already given up two pinfalls. And now Justin Lee wrapping up the legs there. Oh, he's got it cinched in. Squeezing, pulling on Kane. His whole body has to be feeling that. Cade gets out of it. The power. It's too much. And the size of him as well, as he just tosses Lee across the ring. Xander's back in, and Xander gets tossed down too. Cade saying, "Don't worry, Xander. I got one for you too." Open Xander fighting out of it. And look at this. What can he be thinking? Another X-Bomb on top of the steps! What's he thinking here? Oh, big clothesline there by Xander. This is the opportunity he needs. He just needed to get Justin Lee out of the ring. Two. And three, Xander ties it up. We're three all here tonight in your main event at Halloween Havoc. Oh, through the table! And the pin. One, two, three. Xander takes the lead. And gets tossed for it. Kane is pissed after he's just been tossed through a flaming table. Oh my God, Xander's dead. His neck has to be broken. Oh, he's getting up. Oh, and he gets the table in the face. This is Havoc. This is Havoc tonight. Justin Lee with the table now. Go for the pin. Trying to tie it up, but Kane is not dead yet. Justin Lee now. Oh! Huge punch. And now locking down Kane with the ladder. What is Justin thinking here? All hell has broken loose in this insane main event tonight. And a great DDT by Justin Lee as both now Kane and Lee climb the ladder. Looks like Kane got up there first and he knocks Lee down. What is Kane thinking? Oh my God, leg drop, brother, from the top of the ladder. Xander looks to steal it. Lifting up Xander on that top turnbuckle. What could he be thinking here? Oh my God. On top of the ladder. Oh my God. Right through it. The pace of the match has slowed down for a second. And Kane feeding Justin Lee a huge strike. He doesn't want to lose his title here tonight. Justin Lee now. Big punch. Straight out of Connecticut with a punch like that. And now Justin Lee looking to fly. Oh, frog splash! Frog splash! He got all of it! Oh, and Xander breaks it up by falling on top of himself! But that gave Justin Lee the perfect opportunity! Drunken driver by Justin Lee! And the pin! One, two, Lee! And that's the three count there! And he ties it up 2-2. Xander and Justin Lee are tied up while Kane is a point behind. But he looks to redeem that. Only a one count as Xander breaks it up. And now just tossing Xander right on top of that ladder. And now he looks to pin him again. One, two. Only a two count because Xander had stopped it earlier. It gave Lee that extra bit of time to survive. And we're still tied up with 2 minutes left here. If Kane can't tie this up, this is gonna end in a draw for Lee and Xander, and they'll end up getting the tiebreaker. So Kane has got to do something here, at least tie it in a pile driver by Justin Lee.
Oh, the kendo stick to the dome piece. And the pin's in, it looks to steal it. Two. Three. Xander takes the lead with a minute and 30 seconds left. And tosses Kane. All he has to do is survive and not allow another pinfall. But he gets cocky, and it costs him something big here. And he gets a knee out, and we've seen this earlier, power slam by Kane. And Justin Liddell. Irish whip into that turnbuckle. Big headbutt to the gut. Now he turns his attention to Xander. And a huge pile driver. Looks like he caught some of that table as well. With 40 seconds, can he score a point to tie it up? Two. Three. Justin Lee ties it up. As Kane has fallen behind by 2 points. With 30 seconds, it looks like we might be going to overtime. But we still got some time left. Xander with those strikes and now trying to take Lee out. Stops Justin from climbing. We have 10 seconds left, folks. What is Xander thinking? Oh! 5 seconds, he's got to pin someone. Two, one.
Justin Lee and Xander go to a draw, which means they will go to sudden death overtime.
And you heard it there from Jimmy Justice. We are going to overtime here at Halloween Havoc between Justin Lee and Xander. You couldn't have written a better story here. As both these men are getting hyped up in their respective corners, we are going to find out who the new national champion is going to be as the strikes go back and forth between Lee and Xander as Justin calls him on. Kicks to the legs, trying to chop down the legs of the big man. Jason versus Freddy, Justin versus Xander. The striking combos by Xander now to Justin Lee. You gotta think, he's been wanting to do this for such a long time, and now he has an opportunity to do it for the national championship. Big German suplex. And now goes for a pin. One, two, and the next person to get a pinfall, I believe, does take the title home. Nice kick there by Xander. With no time limit set up, all he has to do is get a win here. Take all the time he needs to take out Justin Lee. He's got to be thinking what to do next. What a hellacious battle between all of these men. Unfortunately for Kane, I mean, he didn't even get to be in the final there. He lost by 2 points. That's a huge upset there from one of the more dominant national champions in ROC. Now we are guaranteed a new champion at Halloween Havoc as these two go back and forth with the strikes. And they know each other so well. Reading each other's movements here. Irish whip there. Justin Lee, well timed. Oh, big power slam by Justin. One, two, almost a three count. Good there by Justin Lee as well. Got to keep the offense on Xander and keep the big man down. And again, one, two, oh, only a one count. Nice headbutt there. Nice punch. Slowing down the pace here from what we've seen earlier. But Xander catching Justin Lee off guard. And a big clothesline. Lifts him up here. The much slower pacing than earlier. And he shoves his full body into Justin Lee. All that weight being thrust upon the stomach of Justin. What a big knee to the face. What a war here tonight. Xander looks onward with the table in hand. He's setting it up for something. I'm not sure what X is thinking here, but he's looking to give it to you. And with this, he just might know Justin Lee gets out of it. Both these men hungry for that championship. He's calling him on. Feeds him with a punch. Feeds him with another. Off the rope, Justin Lee. Oh, just diving his full body into him. No, wait. Did Xander get a knee up? That was so smart by Xander. I barely caught it. He got a knee up and stopped Justin Lee right before he hit him. And now, oh, he gets caught by Justin. And now Justin Lee looking to fly. Oh, he just misses him there and dives right on him. A referee outside calling the action here on the outside, making sure nothing too crazy happens. We don't want a murder here, although both these men may already be dead. Oh! Now Justin Lee looking to fly. Frog splash! They take the table out with him and the pin. We're gonna have Justin Lee. No! What? Xander kicked out, not even at one. Oh my God. Jason will not stay down. But Justin Lee lights the table on fire, but that may be, he may have just caused his own death here. No, he fights out of it. Now he sets Xander up on that turnbuckle. Repeated shots to the head now. Xander sits down, taking a breather, but that might not be the best place for him. As Justin Lee's full body weight goes driving down onto him. And now Justin Lee looks to fly. And he's signaling for it. Here we go. Oh my God, he got out of the way. Right through the flaming table into a huge X-bomb by Xander. 1, 2, 3, the boyhood dream has come true.
Here is your winner and the new ROC National Champion of the World, Xander.
He has finally done it. Xander is your new national champion. What a win. What a performance. The main event, Halloween Havoc. This is a night he will never forget in his life. Mama Xander, baby boy, dream has finally come true here tonight at Halloween Havoc. Thank you all for joining us. And wait, what the hell is this? It's Dane Xavier! That's all the time we have.